Welcome back. We are now moving on to the fifth and final module in our course on communication skills. If you have arrived at this module, that means you have completed the other four modules and you are well on your way to becoming a successful communicator and communicating effectively and efficiently. Congratulations! In this module, we will talk about an aspect that is very important in communication. This is how we manage our feelings and emotions during communication. Feelings and emotions, you may ask. What does that have to do with communication? Communication is just interacting with someone else and exchanging ideas, trying to inform them, maybe persuade them, maybe convince them about something. Where do my emotions come into it? You might wonder. Well, your feelings and your emotions are a big part of how you communicate, as it is for everyone else. And so it is important we address our feelings and emotions. Think about it. When you're upbeat, when you're happy, it shows in the way you communicate. You may have a smile on your lips. You may be positive in the way you interact with others. Whereas if you're tired, if you're down in the dumps, if you're upset about something, if you're sleepy, you may tend to be cranky, you may not be receptive to somebody else's ideas, you may snap at people, you may get angry with them unnecessarily. So our emotions do reflect in the way we communicate. Therefore, understanding our emotions and feelings will help us get a handle on them. And we will be able to better control them, which means we can engage in better and more effective communication. So with that said, let's get started on this final module. And before you know it, you will see yourself being a successful communicator, someone who's positive, someone who's able to communicate well, and someone who is rewarded with success in his or her career. Recognition, pay raises, all of these will come your way as you enter the world of effective communication. These are the basic concepts we're going to address here. We're going to talk about how to become aware of your feelings and emotions. We will talk about understanding your feelings and emotions using the fight versus flight response. We will talk about understanding other people's emotions and feelings. And we will talk about how to manage stress. If you can keep your stress under control, you will see that your communication skills do not take a hit, but instead, you are able to communicate effectively and efficiently. Let us first talk about understanding feelings and emotions. This is a huge topic. We are merely skimming the surface here. And we will outline one simple idea. We will talk about stress and emotions, and we will look at a simple scientific exercise that is felt to be effective in managing stressful situations. This is adapted from the book by Dr. Luskin. So let's go ahead and talk about what emotions and feelings do when we're communicating. When we communicate, our feelings are what help us communicate well or hinder us or stop us from communicating well. To understand this, we have to look back and reflect on how our minds and our bodies react to stressful situations. In today's world, our minds have evolved to protect our bodies against external threats. If left to itself, our mind is always looking for potential threats to our survival. When it senses such a threat, it unleashes a series of changes in the body. What are these changes? Well, your heart starts pounding, your muscles become tense, you may experience sweaty or clammy hands, wet with sweat. There is increased blood flow to your arms and legs. Your body may even become rigid. This is all to prepare you to fight the enemy or to run away to safety. That's how our safety mechanism rushes to help us out. It tells us, well, run away and hide, or stand your ground and fight. This is normal and universal. It is automatic. You do not have control over it. In fact, it is very necessary for our survival. If we don't have this fight or flight instinct, we may not survive. So, for example, if you were to encounter a lion in the jungle, you wouldn't survive without this instinct. If you encounter a lion, you'll stop and assess the situation. Should I stand here and fight? Maybe I have, a fire on a log and I can ward off the lion with it. I can scare the lion away. Or maybe I just need to run because that is the best way to protect myself. Well, guess what? We're not living in the jungle. You're not facing a lion. But you do face other kinds of threats that you have to survive. And we are going to talk about that next. What are these threats that we face? If it's not the lion in a jungle, what could possibly be the problem that we have to deal with in such an evolved manner? Well, let's look at it. As I said, the threats that we face are potentially different today. What we encounter is not a lion in the jungle, but an angry boss, or maybe a rude service agent. It could be a rude client, somebody who is bent upon making us look bad. Our mind perceives these issues in the same way as the lion in the jungle is a threat to us. And this generates the same reaction in our body, namely stress. What does stress do? Well, stress can be very, very counterproductive. It causes our thinking to shut down. Rational thought goes flying out the window. It causes symptoms in our body where we are stressed out and we get ready to fight. We don't stop to think. We perhaps say the very first thing that comes to our mind. This is not always the best thing to do. If you've come this far in our course in communication, you know you want to think before you speak. You don't want to say the first thing that comes into your head without even reflecting upon it. So what should we do then? Well, certainly not continue with the first response that comes to our minds, because that won't produce a desirable outcome for us or for anyone else. If you can understand that when you are stressed out, the thoughts that come into your head are not the best ways to react, that is the first step to keeping your cool. You can then cultivate a positive attitude and manage your emotions. To put it succinctly and simply, your attitude and your positive thoughts are the key ingredients to manage your emotions. If you can keep your cool under stressful situations, you are already a winner in the act of communication. You have mastered the act of communication. Well, yes, that may all be, but how do you manage to master it? How do you know that you have been effective in managing stress? Well, research shows that the simple act of slow, deep, and regular breathing signals to your body that the threat has passed and that the body can begin to calm down. So perhaps when you're stressed out, when you're angry, when you're affected, when you're emotional, just slow down. Take deep, slow, regular breaths. And you will notice that all those parts of your body that were getting tensed are beginning to calm down. Your breathing normalizes. The blood flow becomes slower and regular. Sweaty palms are not sweating anymore. You're not angry and tensed and rigid. You're not clenching your fists, but you're slowly beginning to calm down. You're slowly beginning to think rationally and effectively. This is a very effective tool to manage stressful situations. If you learn to control your breathing, that may be the single greatest gift you can give yourself. It allows you to reflect. It allows you to think about what would be the best step to take under these circumstances, and it allows you to engage in effective and efficient communication. You can then mask your anger or the fact that you're upset, and you can allow your rational mind to take over and deal with the situation in an appropriate and effective manner. So then let's talk about what exactly the steps for this deep breathing exercise are. As I said before, this is adapted from Dr. Luskin's stress-free for good idea. Well, step one, place your hands on your belly while you slowly inhale. Step two, as you inhale, imagine that your belly is like a balloon that you're slowly filling with air. So take in the air, take it in. Step three, watch your hands rise as you slowly breathe in. Step four, watch your hands fall as you slowly breathe out, letting the air out of the balloon, which is your belly. If you can practice this for 5 or 10 minutes at a time every single day, you will learn how to control and curb stress. You can practice this at any time. When you're waiting in traffic, while you're watching TV, when you're walking to exercise, or even when you're sitting on the computer and doing this course, use this exercise and you will see when you become tense, when you're angry or nervous, when you need to take a pause and think before speaking, when you need to reflect before you say anything that you would later regret, when you want to avoid saying something, when you have trouble falling asleep, when you're angry, in any of these situations, this deep breathing can certainly calm you down. It is a valuable tool, and be sure you use it. Keep in mind, we have talked about a lot of ways in which we can control our communication skills, a lot of ways in which we can exercise effective communication skills. Managing stress is an important aspect of effective communication. As you look back at this course, you will see there are a great many tools that we have given you in this course. Hopefully, you will retain them, you will practice them, and you will improve upon your communication. And you will notice, little by little, that you are an effective communicator. Congratulations, and thank you.